Hey guys, it's Nick. Welcome to another episode of T-Minus 365. Many of us out there have seen the intelligent meeting recap from Microsoft Teams Premium, which includes a lot of the AI functionality that really drew us to that product. In my mind, it was the biggest marketing pull for me to go take a look at that product. But now with the introduction of Microsoft 365 Copilot and Copilot within Teams, I wanted to make a video to just quickly depict what comes with Teams Premium licensing and what AI capabilities you do get within Microsoft Copilot that aren't part of Teams Premium. So stay tuned, I'll be showing a lot of demos from Microsoft in this video, just kind of depicting the major differences and going through the major functionality of Teams Premium, including some pricing information. I think that's really important as well. As always, like and subscribe if you want to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. Otherwise, let's go ahead and dive in. Okay, so getting into it here, this is a direct comparison side by side of the feature sets with Microsoft Teams Premium and then Copilot for Microsoft 365. The only thing I've done is add some pricing information. So stay tuned, because at the end of the video, I'm going to be going through that. There's some unique caveats with commitments, prepaid annual, things like that, that you'll want to know as well. But if you take a look at this, a high level summary that I can provide is that Teams Premium is more of your power users of meetings, appointments, scheduling, maybe some webinars that you do across the organization, versus Copilot, which is more of this immersive AI experience. I'll be able to show you that through demos, but as you can see here through the key, these are the AI features, and the only overlap that we have here is this intelligent meeting recap. So again, that's what I kind of briefly showed, and I'll go into more depth with as we go through this video. But that, and then the real-time translation, which is giving you the ability to translate from one language into closed captions of another, is really the only two AI-related features that are highlighted as part of this feature set. So I wanted to quickly go through a demo of a majority of these features just so you can see what capabilities exist, because some of these I didn't even know what they were really talking about till I investigated, and I did want to see that visual so I can showcase that, and then I'll be showcasing more of the enablement content or the actual enhancements of the AI features you get within Teams with Copilot versus what you get in Teams Premium. Okay, so some of the security enhancements that you do get within Microsoft Teams are really an upgrade from what you get in the normal Teams. So you have sensitivity labels, which you can apply for data protection, data exfiltration protection as well too. And then you have things like watermarks that you can apply to shared screens or your video content to help protect sensitive data within meetings as well. The other thing that you can do within the Teams admin experience is really getting into end-to-end encryption on a larger scale. So you do have encryption capabilities on one-on-one meetings, but when you talk about the group setting, that does not exist. So you're extending that into the end-to-end encryption. You can apply that in meeting templates, which I'll get to here in a second. And additionally, you can automatically blur backgrounds as part of the settings as well too. So that's another really powerful feature, I think, just to have that out of the box for users in case you don't have a background selected as well. Some of the more advanced collaboration tools, you have this priority account chat, which is really just blocking internal users from chatting with another. And this might be your CEO that doesn't want to get a bunch of spam from internal users, and you can block that person within your meeting experience. Some of the advanced collaboration analytics here gets into a lot of your advanced metrics, such as, you know, inactive teams that you might have, but also kind of the external collaboration and volume of that across certain users or groups within the organization. So it's a lot more leaning into the security aspect of this, where you can maybe see the domains that you're interacting with, more of that external user base and the highest users with activity with external users in the organization. So that's a lot of capabilities that you get there with some more of those advanced analytics. When we talk about customization, you can do virtual backgrounds that are more company branded. And the same thing is true when you're in the meeting as well, as you can see here. This is a lot of capabilities that you'd like to have for just overall branding from a marketing sense. But then when we talk about meetings and being able to customize all the settings, it does get pretty repetitive in the nature of which you have to modify those settings, maybe for a meeting that's consistent or a meeting that contains certain sensitive information. So within the premium experience, you can set up meeting templates that you can apply to a meeting that you have all the predefined settings as well too. It's a pretty powerful experience. The other piece that you have here from a virtual appointment standpoint is the ability to integrate SMS for SMS reminders of that meeting. You have the ability for users to join Teams Mobile on the web without having to have the thick client or anything of that nature. And then with virtual appointments just in general, you have a lot of scheduling capabilities that you can do natively and chat with those users within Teams, as well as seeing certain analytics about usage within the organization as well. Teams Premium is also built geared for users leveraging webinars quite a lot within the organization. You can have things like a registration waitlist that can automatically admit people as soon as there becomes a gap within there. You also have the ability to see what users have filled out from a form perspective, and then additionally have automated email reminders that could go out about that webinar to the attendees that are participating in that event. And lastly, you also have this capability called Green Room, which allows you basically to have moderators prior to the meeting starting to talk about the meeting agenda, look at Q&A, things like that. And this is just giving you the ability to also bring people on the screen. So a lot of customizability for that overall webinar experience. Now, when we start getting into the AI capabilities, we have things like the intelligent summarization or translation of one language to another. And so Microsoft has tons of languages that they can work with within this experience, and AI is actually doing that translation from, you know, one language to the other in the closed captions of that particular experience. And here we can actually see somebody being translated from Chinese to English as part of the subtitles.
现在即便我使用中文,你也可以理解我在说什么。这就是我们如何使用人工智能,将人们聚集在一起,无论他们身在何处或使用何种语言。
Next here, we have intelligent meeting recap, which I went through briefly at the beginning of this call. But effectively, this has some of the similar features that Copilot has, in that we can see kind of that color bar chart of who was talking and when they were talking, some more of the heavy level indicators in the meeting where you maybe were at mentioned to get called out. And then you can see things like the at mentions on the side. But additionally, when you go into that, you can also see the AI driven notes as well, which again summarizes the meeting, pretty succinct bullet points, as well as looking at any follow-up items that would be required of the meeting as well. So kind of the action items coming out of that meeting. And that's definitely one of the most popular features that we see as part of this as well too. So now that we've covered that, let's get into more of what is the expansion of AI that you get within Copilot and that Teams meeting experience. So one of the things that's really powerful that you can begin to do within this experience, in this screenshot or video, you can go ahead and if you're not able to make a meeting, you can actually follow the meeting as well. And what this does behind the scenes is it's actually going to send you a notification when that meeting is over with the entire meeting recap for you. So it's a little bit more proactive in what you can do. So you get the same kind of analytics that you do with the intelligent recap as far as the follow-up tasks, the at mentions, the notes of the meeting being bullet points and being pretty succinct as well. But then additionally, this is where the main value comes into play. You can actually chat with Copilot, which is chatting with the transcript summary, and you can ask it basically any question like you see here, where you're asking, hey, you know, what was the proposal leading out of that meeting and other things of that nature. So it's a more powerful experience to just interact and get more of a back and forth with the transcript. The other thing that you can do here is actually intra-meeting or intra-call, interact with Copilot chat to start to summarize things like recap this meeting so far as this example that you can see in here. But then you can also get things like, in this case, sentiment of the group as well. And this is all coming from the transcript within Teams. I think that's a really powerful experience just to be able to summarize that, or if you came in late, to get caught up on that meeting. The other thing that you can do here with a PSDN call even is to interact with the transcript and be able to summarize things as well too. So in this case, we're talking with potentially a customer who's on the other end of the line, and we can ask things like, what, you know, should we be asking in this particular context given the existing conversation so far? And in this case, they're also asking for any unresolved questions too. So it's a really powerful experience. And in this case, the representative is actually going to transfer this call to maybe somebody who's more knowledgeable on those particular topics. And so this is where it becomes very powerful, in that so you can quickly just chat up, in this case, Adele, and start to copy and paste the summarization from Copilot as well as the unresolved questions. So if you think about that, that's going to speed up the time in which the end customer is actually waiting to get transferred. But then additionally, it's giving them everything that they need to know very succinctly as part of that call as well too. So very powerful experience that you get with that as well. And this is really playing into a lot of the things that are part of the more powerful experience. The last part here is just interacting with Microsoft 365 chat. And this is just chat within Teams or within the chat app itself on the side. But as you can see here, you can ask questions about meetings and it'll recap that on the fly. What I think the other powerful piece here is the ability to interact with multiple suite offerings. In this case, we're saying, hey, summarize the meeting from yesterday, but also then draft me an email to recap it for my team that I can send over. And that's a really powerful experience as well too, because you can interact with both and you can then summarize what you would want to pull into Outlook. One thing that we have to consider though is with Microsoft Copilot, you actually get the graph context within that. And that is to say that we're folding in all the layers and indexing everything within your environment that you have access to, including your shared repositories, your Outlook inbox, your OneDrive folders, your Teams chats, your Teams meetings, to really present and provide a much better answer to you. I showed this in my last week's video where I asked Copilot to say, hey, reference all the locations in which I've been talking about live chat, and it sourced things from my Teams repositories that were shared, sourced it from chat messages, things like that. So it's more of an integrated experience across everything that I do within Microsoft versus that isolated context of just Teams meetings as well. So the last thing I want to mention here and just call out is the pricing information, just so you have a clear information on that as well too. So this is a pretty disparate price point here that you see, $30 user a month versus seven. Obviously, based off of what I showed you, there's a whole lot of additional AI capabilities that you do get with Microsoft 365 Copilot. I still believe though that for certain SMBs, Microsoft Teams Premium might be a good gateway to start to tap into some of the AI capabilities and showcase that to a customer and say, hey, if you really like that, think about if you could do these things within Copilot as well. Certainly, again, a heavy price point to swallow. Microsoft's coming out with more information. I'll certainly highlight this in a future video about ROI, but they showcase that if you spend about or save about 54 minutes per month as the average user, you're actually making 100% return on your investment given a 70K salary or something like that, I think. So it's really interesting. And if you say, oh, I saved a couple hours, maybe that's a 2X, 3X ROI on that particular solution. The other thing that's hard to grasp right now is that this is annual prepaid commitment, meaning that you have to spend $360 a user upfront versus Teams Premium. It does have an annual commit where you get this at $7 a user a month, but you can pay month to month. You don't have to prepay in that sense. They also additionally have a month-to-month option under the NCE terms, so it's a 20% premium over the existing costs. It's gonna be $840 a user a month with that, but again, you have the flexibility to say, let me trial this for a month, which is actually a good point on trials. This has a trial, this does not have a trial. And I think that's just because of how much compute this consumes and they don't want people to be able to maximize that because they're really stressed, I think, right now from the resource perspective to support all these AI capabilities. So things to keep in mind from a pricing perspective, definitely can set up a trial of Teams Premium. If you're a heavy Teams shop that uses meetings a lot, tries to do a lot of customer webinars, things like that, definitely think it's worth looking into. And then with Copilot saying, hey, you want to step up into these more advanced features. Okay, so that's everything I had for you guys in today's video. Definitely comment below with any other questions you have about Teams Premium licensing AI capabilities versus Microsoft Copilot. Happy to answer any questions. And as always, like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, like and subscribe to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. I'll see you guys in the next video.